Hey guys, in this video we will see blood coagulation. It is one of the mechanisms of hemostasis and usually occurs parallel to the platelet plaque formation. In video of platelet plaque formation, we saw that after injury, break-in vessel wall is initially sealed by platelets and primary platelet plaque is formed. Soon starts the coagulation which converts this plaque into definitive clot. It starts by two pathways, intrinsic pathway and extrinsic pathway. Both of them merge at common pathway. Now let's see them in detail. First, intrinsic pathway. It takes place on the negatively charged surface of activated platelets. It is called intrinsic because it starts with factor that lies within the blood. First factor to get activated in this pathway is factor 12. High molecular weight kininogen anchors factor 12 to the platelet surface. Upon contact with negative surface, the factor 12 is activated to factor 12A. Activation by this way is very slow. However, the small quantity of factor 12A that is generated convert prekallikrein into kallikrein. The kallikrein then speeds up activation of factor 12. Then comes factor 11, which is activated by factor 12A by proteolysis. Next is factor 9. It is one of those factors whose synthesis is dependent on vitamin K. It has gamma carboxyglutamic acid residue which has negative charge. It helps the factor to bind with membrane phospholipid via positively charged calcium ions. Then it is activated by factor 11. Activated factor 9 associates with factor 8. And factor 8, 9, calcium and phospholipid form a complex called 10As. As per its name, 10S complex activates factor 10. Factor 10 is first member in common pathway. Now let's see the extrinsic pathway. It is called extrinsic because it starts with factor which lie outside the blood. See, under healthy condition, endothelial cells prevent exposure of blood to the tissue factor. But when endothelium is disrupted, the tissue factor is exposed. So now factor 7 from the blood binds with tissue factor. Then tissue factor activates factor 7 in non-proteolytic manner. They further associate with calcium and form tissue factor, factor 7A calcium complex. It is similar to this 10S complex that we just saw. Like 10S, this complex also activates factor 10, which is common end product of intrinsic and extrinsic pathway. So now let's move to the common pathway. Here, factor 10 associates with factor 5A and forms one more complex along with calcium and phospholipid. It is called prothrombinase. And as per its name, it acts on inactive prothrombin and converts it into active thrombin. Thrombin thus generated converts fibrinogen into fibrin monomer. Now multiple fibrin monomers undergo spontaneous polymerization to form fibrin polymers which create a loose mesh around platelets. Finally comes the role of factor 13, also called fibrin stabilizing factor. It is activated by thrombin to factor 13A. It causes covalent cross-linking of fibrin polymers to form stable fibrin. Coagulation converts primary platelet plug into definitive clot. Apart from platelets, other blood cells like red blood cells and white blood cells also get trapped when the clot is being formed. Composition of the clot varies depending on where it is formed. Arterial clots have high proportion of platelets, whereas venous clots have high proportion of fibrin. That's all about coagulation. Now it's time for summary. Coagulation can start with intrinsic pathway and extrinsic pathway. Both of them merge at common pathway. Intrinsic pathway is activated when blood comes in contact with negative surface. It converts factor 12 into factor 12A. Kallikrein also helps this process. Activated factor 12 activates factor 11, which activates factor 9. Factor 9 forms complex with factor 8A, calcium and phospholipid called 10As. It activates factor 10. Extrinsic pathway starts with exposure of tissue factor. It activates factor 7. Then factor 7 in association with tissue factor and calcium activate factor 10. At common pathway, factor 10, factor 5A and calcium form prothrombinase complex that converts prothrombin into thrombin. Thrombin converts fibrinogen into fibrin monomers. Fibrin monomers polymerize spontaneously to form fibrin polymers. Factor 13, which is activated by thrombin, covalently cross-links fibrin polymers and forms stable fibrin. This process lays down fibrin mesh for clot formation. Arterial clots are mainly made up of platelets and venous clots of fibrin. A point I want to add here is thrombin is also involved in activation of factor 8 and factor 5. It also contributes in activation of platelets as we saw in video of platelet plug formation. That's it friends for this video. If you are a visual learner, you will like to see more videos at our channel. Please check them out. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.